birds that rise from the lake to the trees. My heart wants to sigh like a chime that flies from a church on a breeze. To laugh like a brook when it trips and falls over stones in its way. To sing through the night like a lark who is learning to pray. I go to the hills when my heart is lonely. I know I will hear what I've heard before. My heart will be blessed with the sound of music, and I'll sing once
Mother, but we simply cannot find Maria.
She's missing again.
Perhaps we should tie a cowbell around her neck.
Now, Sister Bertha.
We simply cannot find her.
Have you checked the barn? You know how much she adores the animals.
We've looked everywhere, in all the usual places.
Sister, considering it's Maria, I suggest you look in the unusual places. We should be pleased with our efforts. Out of 20 postulants, 16 or 17 are ready to enter the novitiate. Let's consider the doubtful ones again.
Well, after last night, I don't think there can be any doubts about Maria.
I gave her permission to leave the Abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Bertha.
But she was late.
I always try to keep faith in my doubt.
After all, a wool of black sheep is just as warm.
We are not talking about sheep. We are talking about candidates for the novitiate.
I see a point.
Of all the candidates, Maria is the least.
Children, children. Let us all take a deep breath. Now, what do we really think of our child Maria?
She's a wonderful girl, some of the time.
And it's very easy to like Maria, except when it's difficult.
Sister Sophia, they do not see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
I love her very dearly, but she does seem to get in trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I say.
She climbs a tree and scrapes her knee, her dress has got a tear. She waltzes on her way to mass and whistles on the stair. And underneath her wimples she has curlers in her hair. I've even heard her singing in the Abbey.
She's always late for chapel,
but her penitence is real.
She's always late for everything except
out of focus and bemused, and I never know exactly where I am.
solve a problem like Maria. How do you catch a cloud and pin it down? How you find a word that means Maria?
A fluttering divot, a will o' the wind.
Many a thing you know you'd like to tell her. Many a thing she ought to understand.
I should talk to Maria instead of about her. I'm grateful to you all. Sit down, Maria.
Reverend Mother, I was on my knees most of the night because I was late.
We could only think you had lost your way.
I couldn't be lost on that mountain. I was brought up on it. It was that mountain that brought me to you.
Oh?
When I was a little girl, I used to come down the mountain, climb a tree, and look over into your garden. I'd see the sisters at work, and I'd hear them singing on their way to Vespers. Many times I went back up that mountain in the dark, singing all the way. And that brings up another transgression.
Maria, it's only here in the Abbey that there is a rule about singing.
That's the hardest rule of all for me.
The day you were singing in the garden at the top of your voice, I wish you hadn't stopped. I used to sing that song when I was a little girl, and I can't quite remember. Please.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens,
brown paper packages
tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
Cream colored ponies and crisp apple strudels,
doorbells and sleigh bells with schnitzel with noodles,
wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings.
These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes,
snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes,
silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply
brought up on that mountain myself. Tell me, Maria, what is the most important lesson you've learned here in the Abbey?
To find out what is the will of God and to do it.
Maria, it seems to be the will of God that you leave us.
Leave? Oh no, Mother, this is what I want. This is my life.
But are you ready for it? Perhaps if you go out into the world for a time, you will return to us knowing what we expect of you and that we do expect
it. I know what you expect.
Maria.
If it is God's will, where am I to go?
There's a family of 7 children. They need a governess until September.
September?
Captain Von Trapp expects you this afternoon. He's a fine man, and a brave one. He was awarded a medal for heroism in the Adriatic.
A captain in the Navy? Oh, Mother, he'll be very strict.
You're not being sent to his battleship. Bless you, Maria.
Thank you. Why did the last governess leave?
Who knows?
She just said I had enough of this and walked out.
Well, there's another one coming today, from Naumburg Abbey, with orders to stay until September.
I hope you'll be at home for a time, sir.
I should be back from Vienna in a few weeks.
Oh, there's a call for you, sir, from Vienna. I have the number.
I know the number.
Of course, sir. You will wait here.
I am Captain Von Trapp. You are Fräulein...
Maria Rainer.
Now, as to your duties here, before the children meet you, you will put on another dress.
I haven't any other dress. When we enter the abbey, our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
What about this one?
Oh, the poor didn't want this one. I would have made myself a dress, but I wasn't given time. I can make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see to it that you're given some materials. Today, if possible. Now, you will be in charge of my children. There are 7 of them. You will see how far they have progressed in their studies and carry on from there. You will see that at all times they conduct themselves with decorum and orderliness. The first rule in this house is discipline.
Yes, sir.
This is the new governess, Fräulein Maria. When I sound your signal, you will step forward and repeat your name. You, Fräulein, will listen and learn their signals.
Liesel. Friedrich. Luisa. Kurt. Brigitte. Marta.
And that's Gretel. Now, Fräulein, when I want you, this is what you'll hear.
You won't have to trouble, sir, because I couldn't answer to a whistle.
That's nonsense. Everyone in this house answers to a whistle. Here, I'll show you. My butler, Franz. The housekeeper, Frau Schmidt. This is the new governess, Fräulein Maria. Please see that her room is ready.
Yes, sir.
Pardon me, sir, but I don't know how to address you.
You will call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. I forgot to return this, Captain. I won't need it, Captain. Are you leaving us, Captain?
I will be in Vienna for a few weeks on business. When I return, I expect a full report on the children's progress and on yours. You are in command.
Well, now that there's just us, would you tell me your names again and tell me how old you are? Now, you're...
I'm Liesel. I'm 16, and I don't need a governess.
I'm glad you told me. We'll just be friends.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14. I'm a boy.
Boy? Why, you're almost a man.
I'm Brigitte.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Luisa. I'm Brigitte. She's Louisa, and she's 13 years old, and you're smart. I'm 9, and I think your dress is the ugliest one I ever saw.
Brigitte, you mustn't say a thing like that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
If I did think so, I wouldn't say so.
I'm Kurt, and I'm 11. Almost.
That's a nice age to be. 11. Almost.
I'm Marta, and I'm going to 7 on Tuesday, and I'd like a pink parasol.
Pink is my favorite color, too. And you're Gretel. I'm going to tell you something. I've never been a governess before. How do I start?
You mean you don't know anything about being a governess?
No.
Well, the first thing you have to do is tell Father to mind his own business.
No, Louisa, don't. I like her.
What's in here? My guitar, for when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
Everybody sings. What songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
You don't?
No.
Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing.
Let's start at the very beginning. A very good place to start. When you read, you begin with
ABC.
When you sing, you begin with Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi. The first three notes just happen to be
listen. Do, re, mi, fa, so, and so on? No. Do, re, mi, fa, so, and so on are only the tools we use to build a song. Once we have these notes in our heads, we can sing a million different tunes.
How?
By mixing them up. Listen. So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re. Now you do it.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
Now let's put it all together.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do.
When you know the note, true.
children, it's time for your exercise.
Do we have to?
Come along now, come along.
Your room is ready, Fräulein Maria. I hope you find it satisfactory.
It's already the most beautiful room I've ever had. What are those?
The old curtains from your room.
It looks like they have plenty of wear left in them.
The new ones have been hung.
When the children return from their exercise, I think I'll have them change into their play clothes and I'll take them.
The children have no such clothes. The Von Trapp children do not play. They march. And you can put that away. You won't be using it.
Why not?
The captain won't have music here.
He won't have music?
And he used to love music. His wife would sing, and he would play the violin or guitar, but since her death, he shut all that out of his life.
So that's why he's the way he is. But not to have music, that's wrong for him and wrong for the children, too.
I agree, Fräulein, but you'll find that the captain is very set in his ways. Now allow me to show you to your room. It's going to rain soon, so when we get there, you better close your window.
Well, good night, Roll.
You don't have to say goodnight this early. Your father isn't home.
How did you know my father wasn't home?
Oh, I have my way of knowing things.
How could you possibly know 2 days ago that you'd be here at this time with a telegram for Franz?
Every year he gets a birthday telegram from his sister. Can I come again tomorrow night?
Rolf, you can't be so sure you're going to have another telegram to deliver tonight.
I could come here by mistake and deliver a telegram from Colonel Schneider. He's here from Berlin. Oh, you weren't supposed to know that. Don't tell your father.
Why not?
He's pretty Austrian.
Well, we're all Austrian.
Some people think we ought to be German, and they get mad at people who don't think so.
Well, I'm sure I'll have forgotten about it all by the time Father gets home. Don't worry.
The only one I worry about is his daughter.
Me? Why?
How old are you, Liesl?
16. What's wrong with that?
Little girl on an empty stage for fate to turn the light on. Your life, little girl, is an empty page that men will want to write on.
Scared am I of things being
and thigh side. God bless Liesel and Friedrich, Louisa, Brigitte, Marta, and little Gretel. And, oh yes.
I forgot the other boy. What's his name? Well, God bless what's his name. And dear God, about Liesel, help her to know that I'm her friend and help her to tell me what she's up to.
Well, I was out taking a walk and someone locked the doors earlier than usual. So when I saw your window open, you're not gonna tell Father, are you?
Liesel, were you out taking a walk all by yourself? You know, if we washed that dress out tonight, nobody would notice it tomorrow. And then all of this would be just between you and me. You could put this on. Put your dress in to soak in the bathtub. Then come back here and sit on the edge of my bed, and we'll have a talk.
I told you earlier today that I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Oh, it's you, Gretel. Are you afraid? Come, all of you, up on the bed. Now all we have to do is wait for the boys. We won't see them. Boys are brave.
You boys aren't frightened too, are you?
Oh, no, we were just making sure you weren't.
Was this your idea, Friedrich?
No. It was Kurt's.
That's it. Kurt. That's the one I left out. God bless Kurt.
Why does it do that? Well, the lightning says something to the thunder, and the thunder answers it back.
I wish you wouldn't answer so loud.
Maybe if we all sing loud enough, we won't hear the thunder. Now, just imagine.
High in a hill was a lonely daughter, lay, ho, lay, ho, lay, hee, hoo. Loud was the voice of a lonely daughter,
lay, ho, lay, ho, loo.
Folks in the town, there was quite real louder,
lay, ho, lay, ho, lay, hee, hoo.
Lusty and clear from the goatherd's daughter,
lay, ho, lay, ho, loo.
Oh, ho, lady o' the lee, oh, oh, ho, lady o' the lay.
Children?
No, sir, but I'm sure they'll return shortly. They'll be delighted that you're home.
How like this for the Salzburg Festival. The finest choral group in Austria. The greatest mixed quartet in all of Europe and the best appeal in the world.
Sounds wonderful, Max.
Doesn't it, though? Unfortunately, all I've got is a basso isn't even profundo.
Max, you always come up with a good festival concert.
And why? Because my motto is, never start looking for the people you wind up getting. That's what I've been telephoning Paris, Rome, Stockholm, London.
On my telephone?
How else could I afford it? Me, the lowly third secretary of the Ministry of Education and Culture. Georg, is there a cathedral around here?
Yes, Nuremberg Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good, I'll have to pay them a visit.
What do you want?
Oh, Captain, I didn't, Heil!
Who are you?
I have a telegram for Herr Detweiler.
I am Herr Detweiler.
You've delivered your telegram, now get out!
Georg, he's just a boy.
I am an Austrian. I will not be hiled.
Georg, why don't you look things the way I do? What is going to happen is going to happen. Just be sure it doesn't happen to you.
Hey, Detweiler, you got a long distance call.
Thank you, Franz. Excuse me, Georg.
Oh, Captain, you're home.
Father, you're home! I love you so much!
Straight line! Get cleaned up, get into your uniforms, and report back here. At once! Fräulein, where did you get these abominations?
Out of some curtains. The curtains that used to hang in my bedroom. There was plenty of wear left in them.
Do you mean to say the people of the neighborhood have seen my children wearing old curtains?
Oh, yes.
They've become very popular. Everyone says, there go Captain Von Trapp's children.
My children have always been a credit to my name.
But, Captain, they weren't. They're just unhappy little marching machines.
I don't care to hear from you about my children.
Well, you must hear from someone. You're not home long enough to know them.
I said I don't want to hear.
I know you don't, but you've got to. Take Liesl. Liesl isn't a child anymore. And if you keep treating her as one, Captain, you're going to have a mutiny on your hands. And Friedrich. Friedrich's afraid to be himself. He's shy. He's aloof. Friedrich needs her confidence.
Don't tell me about my son.
Brigitte could tell you about him. She could tell you a lot more if you got to know her because she notices things. And she always tells the truth, especially when you don't want to hear it.
I haven't finished yet. Marta, I don't know about yet, but someone has to find out about her. And little Gretel just wants to be loved. Oh, please, Captain, love Gretel, love all of them. They need you.
Stop! Stop it! You will pack your things and return to the Abbey as soon as possible.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said those things. Not in the way I said them.
After you're gone, there'll be... What's that?
Singing.
Who's singing?
Your children.
My children? Singing?
Georg, you must hear this.
For a thousand years, the hills fill my heart with the sound of music. My heart wants to sing every song it hears. My heart wants to beat like the wings of the birds that flies from the bay.
Edelweiss.
Georg, why haven't you told me how talented your children are?
Children, I'd like you to show Herr Detweiler the gardens.
Yes, do show me the gardens. I'd love to hear you sing their song. Which artist sings so beautifully?
Fräulein Maria.
She also told me to play the guitar.
You are right. I don't know my own children.
They're waiting to know you. I'm gone.
No, I want you to stay.
If I could be of any help.
You've helped already. You've brought music back into my home.
I'm German. I'm Austrian.
You'll see soon enough.
I don't think these people are having a very good time.
Half of the people in the town are angry at the other half. I thought a party would help, but now I'm not so sure.
Kurt, I haven't danced Leonard since I was a little girl.
Oh, you remember? You said the left hand behind the back.
But first the boy and girl meet. Then they go for a little stroll.
No, Kurt, that's wrong. Let me show you.
Remember anymore.
Well, Kurt, that's the way it's done.
Your face is all red. I guess I'm not very used to dancing.
I think it's because Father's in love with you.
Brigida, you shouldn't say things you don't know are true.
But remember the other night when we were all singing the Edelweiss song he taught us? After we finished, you laughed at him for forgetting the words. He didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you.
No, Brigida.
And remember just now when you were dancing? You're in love with him, too.
Maria, you won't be eating dinner with the children tonight. You'll be down here with us.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes, but you'll have to change first. Maria, put on that dress you wore the other night when we were all singing. It was lovely.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Before we get into dinner, Von Chapter would like to say goodnight, as long as they can.
Regretfully, they tell us the fairy.
ladies and gentlemen, dinner is served.
Max, you know how I feel about...
Oh, Georg, they're extraordinary. I've been looking all over Austria for something like this for the festival, and I find it right here?
My children do not sing in public.
But it's important in Austria, and it won't do me any harm.
Take her new posture in the throating room. God bless you, my daughter.
Mother, Maria's here to see you. I know it has taken her a long time.
I waited until she wanted to come to me.
It's strange. She seems happy to be here, but unhappy too.
Why did they send her back? Do you know?
She doesn't speak except in prayer.
I'll see her now.
Maria?
This must have been a trying experience for you.
It was, Reverend Mother.
Has it taught you anything?
I've learned that I never want to leave these walls again.
Why did they send you back to us?
They didn't send me back. I left. I was frightened.
Frightened?
I was confused. I never felt that way before. I couldn't stay, and I knew that here I would be away from it. That here I would be safe.
Maria, our abbey is not to be used as an escape.
But I can't face him again. Those feelings.
Maria, are you in love with Captain Von Trapp?
Brigida said that I was, and that her father was in love with me. But I was there on God's errand. To have asked for the captain's love would have been wrong.
Maria, the love of man and woman is holy too. What you must find out is, how does God want you to spend your love?
I've pledged my life to God's service.
To love a man doesn't mean you love God less. You must find out. You must go back.
Oh no, Mother, please!
These walls were not made to shut out problems. You must face them. You must find the life you were born to live.
How do I find it?
Look for it.
Oh,
That's very nice. Except it's no good. Gretel, why don't you sing loud?
I've got a sore finger. We need Fräulein Maria.
We do not need Fräulein Maria. You can sing just as well with me.
Are you going to long distance call from...
Now who could be calling me?
Max, this isn't the first call you've gotten from Berlin.
Georg, you know I have no political convictions. And anyway, the Germans have promised not to invade Austria.
And if they don't keep their promise?
They don't have some friends among them.
What would you like to sing?
Fräulein Maria!
We are not to mention Fräulein Maria. Luisa, did you play any of your tricks, any of your jokes on Fräulein Maria?
Only those she liked and laughed at.
You didn't put toads in her bed?
No, Father.
Something must have happened. For her to leave us without even saying goodbye?
Isn't Fräulein Maria coming back?
No, darling. I don't think so.
But she was the best governess we've ever had.
Yes. Well, it's time for afternoon walk.
When Fräulein Maria wanted to feel better, she used to sing us that song, remember?
Yes. All right, let's try it.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings.
These are a few of my favorite.
Finger.
You remembered!
Liesl, are you all right?
Yes, Fräulein, I'm all right.
Any telegrams lately?
No, Fräulein. But now I'll be glad to go to boarding school.
Liesl, you can't use boarding school to escape your problems. You have to face them.
Fräulein Maria, you've returned.
Yes, Captain.
Liesl?
Luisa, Brigitte, boys. Maria, we'll be in the nursery.
Maria, a new dress?
We have a new postulant.
You left us without even saying goodbye.
It was wrong of me.
What made you come back?
The Mother Abbess. She said that you have to look for your life.
Often when you don't find it, or when you find it, you don't recognize it first.
No.
Not until one day, one night, when it stands before you.
Yes.
Maria, I look at you now, and I know this is something that has not just happened. You knew it too. What was it that told you?
Brigitte. When we were dancing at the party.
She was quite right. That was no ordinary dance, was it?
I hadn't danced since I was a very little girl. It's quite different after you're grown up, isn't it?
Maria, your whole life will be different now. I'll take you anywhere you want to go, give you anything you wish.
But I don't want to go anywhere. All I could wish for is right here.
You know, those two ought to get together sometime.
Who?
The Mother Abbess and Brigitte. Maria, is there someone I should go to? Task to marry you?
Why don't we ask the children?
Children, children, look! Salzburg Festival, 1938. Look here, the Von Schaff family singers.
Uncle Max, are you sure Father's going to be all right with this?
Brigitte, don't you trust me?
No. Liesl, what do you think?
Uncle Max, when will they be back from the honeymoon?
Not in time for the concert, I'm afraid. What a shame.
Children, see what I have here. That's Father's luggage.
They're home!
Children, we missed you so very much.
What did you miss most?
We missed all that noise you make in the morning. And we missed hearing you sing. Well, you came back just in time to hear us sing. Look, Father, we're going to sing in the Salzburg Festival Friday night.
Let me see that. Max?
I've just been waiting to talk to you about it, Georg.
You can't talk your way out of this one.
Children, look what we found.
Presents!
Give me mine!
Now, Georg, I had to make a last-minute decision. I was very fortunate to be able to end them at all. They'll be the talk of the festival. Seven children in one family?
The Von Trapp family does not sing in public.
But if they make people happy.
It is out of the question.
But the port in Austria.
There is no more Austria.
But the transfer of power happened peacefully. Let's at least be grateful for that.
Grateful?
Maria, you must at least pretend to work for these people. He has to compromise before you're all in danger.
Max, I can't ask Eric to be less than what he is.
Then I will talk to him. If these children don't sing in the festival, well, it'd be a reflection on Austria. It wouldn't do me any good.
Maria, I've always known you've loved us children, and now I know you love Father.
I do, Liesl. I love him very much. What is it, Georg?
This telegram came while we were away. Berlin has offered me a commission in their navy.
What's happened?
While we were gone, the German government took control of Austria. Now they want me to command a ship in their navy.
What will you do?
Well, Georg?
I can't just brush this aside. It'd be a relief to know that my family is safe, but that would mean...
Georg, whatever you decide will be my decision.
I know now that I can't do it.
Of course not.
We'll have to leave Austria. We can't just pack up and go. They'll be watching us. We need time.
Sir, Herr Zoller is here to see you.
Thank you, Franz. Please bring him in. They didn't give us time.
Then we'll have to make time.
Stormtroopers, this was afraid of, Maria.
Max, stay with Georg. Liesl, I need the children. Quickly.
Max, I need you now more than ever. Keep your head about you.
Don't I always?
Captain, may I present Admiral von Schreiber of the Third Reich.
Admiral, and may I present Maximilian Detweiler.
First Secretary of the Ministry of Education and Culture.
That was in the old regime.
In the old regime, I was the third secretary. Now I'm the first secretary.
How nice to have friends. Would you gentlemen care to sit down?
We're here on business.
Captain von Trapp, a telegram was sent to you 3 days ago.
I have just received it.
Captain von Trapp has just returned from his honeymoon, sir.
Congratulations.
Let's get to the point, if you don't mind.
In our Navy, we hold you in very high regard. That explains why I'm here.
I'm very flattered, Admiral, but I've had no time to consider.
Your orders are to report immediately in the naval base in Bremerhaven.
Immediately? Oh, I'm afraid that would be impossible for you, Georg.
Admiral, may I present my wife, the Baroness von Trapp.
Madam.
What I meant, sir, is that we're all singing in the Salzburg Festival Friday night. You see, the von Trapp family singers.
Friday night? That's only a matter of 2 days.
It says here only the names of the children.
It says the von Trapp family singers. I am head of the von Trapp family.
It's hard to believe you, Captain von Trapp, singing in a concert.
Believe what you wish, Herr Zeller.
It doesn't say here what you're going to be singing. What are you going to sing, Captain?
You have the privilege of coming to see us.
I'd like to hear you sing now.
Sing something together. Sing.
Children?
Deer, our female deer, hooray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself.
Far, a long, long way to run.
Ladies and gentlemen, the festival concert has come to its conclusion, except, of course, we don't know what the conclusion is going to be. The judges are putting their heads together to arrive at their decision. In the meantime, I think it should be an encore. It seems this may be the last opportunity the von Trapp family have to sing there for a long, long time. I've just been informed that Captain von Trapp is a meet-up concert for his new command in the Naval Force of the Third Reich. A guard of honor has come next door directly from the hall to the naval base at Bremerhaven. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the family von Trapp again.
Edelweiss, Edelweiss, every morning.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have here the decision of our distinguished judges. We will start with the third award. For this honor, the judges have named the trio of Sagnerbrand of Herrevigen. The second award has been given to Fräulein Schweiger, the first soloist of the choir of St. Agatha's Church, Immerbach. And the first prize, the highest musical in the land, goes to the Family Von Trapp. The Family Von Trapp. Play something.
No, Marta. We have a long drive ahead of us.
Reverend Mother, we can never thank you.
We'll start as soon as it's safe. We've hit our car deep in the woods.
Oh, the car will do you no good. They've left a guard on the road in front of the gates.
We've been listening to the wireless.
All the roads have been blocked. And the border's been closed.
I've always thought of these mountains as my friends, standing there, protecting us. But now, they seem to have become our enemies.
Never your enemies. Haven't you read? I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. Georg, I know that mountain as well as I know this abbey, and so do you. And once we're over that mountain, we're in Switzerland.
But the children.
We can help them.
Mother, we don't need help.
You'll have help. For ye shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth before you in the singing.
Every day.
much for coming. You were by far the best audience, too, I have to say. And I said this last night, but when the audience has the energy, the children have the energy. And they give it to you, and you give it back. And it's just listening backstage is just absolutely amazing. I also said that one of the things we strive to do here is to set the bar really high. I don't have low standards. I have really, really high ones, and I don't like to bring them down. So I make the kids go up to them, and they did. And when they surpass what you expect them, I get goosebumps. It was just absolutely amazing. So bravo, my friends. Excellent job. I have a few very important thank yous. I want to start with our superintendent, Dr. Arzell. Yes. Without her, we wouldn't have what we have today. She's a huge supporter of the arts, and we couldn't be more thankful. And our principal, Mr. Sweeney, assistant principals, Mr. Nenza, and Mrs. Kleehammer, the amount of support that we get to do this kind of production for you is outstanding, and we wouldn't be here without them either. I have some very special people to thank. We have some backstage hands that were super helpful, and I will make you come up here, so. We had a guest director who also works for the district in maintenance, and he was a theater major, and I found this out one day when I met him. So I said, well, why don't you help? And he said, sure. So he came whenever he could. So Jason, I know you're out there. Come on up. And we, you know what's funny about this is, as I'm telling who people are, there are so many people that work in the district in different capacities that came together to help us with this show. So what the most fantastic bus driver that we have, Miss Monica. Come on out. So my daughter sitting up here, she doesn't even take the bus, and every morning she goes out to the bus stop just to say hi to Miss Monica. Our sets back here were built by Mr. Harrison, or Mr. Nowakowski, Harrison's dad, and his mom has helped backstage, Beth. So Beth is still backstage, maybe? Yeah. Make her come out. And Mr. Ryan also helped with our sets. Thank you. And Trish, are you back there too? She's been selling things for us and helping backstage. This doesn't happen with just one person, let me tell you. There are a lot of hands that helped. And Simi, are you out there? Nana's mom. She is our backhand extraordinaire.
Thank you.
Then, so here's something you might not know, but all of these cameras that are set up was by our phenomenal Mr. George Miller. He donates his time, his talents, and he records all of this for us. He comes to every show. He splices the shows together, makes a DVD for each cast and crew member, so everybody will get a copy. And he also came and took stills of both of our dress rehearsals. So everybody gets those pictures too. So it is out of the goodness of his heart. I couldn't imagine a better human being. So thank you, George.
Thank you.
Okay, and my right, left hand, and both feet. Now I have to honor these three lovely ladies. From Little Mountain Community Theater, Mary Beth. Mary Beth came almost every day, helped backstage, whatever. She just said, whatever, tell me what you need to do, I'll do it. So we did, and she did it. So it was awesome, thank you. And Mrs. Manthe.
Catherine. She literally is like a stage manager. She did
all the tickets. She does everything for me. As her husband said, her house looks like a tornado now because of all it's all covered in Sound of Music. I promise you get your house back soon. Okay, and last but not least, Pam, we'd like to say thank you. So Pam comes to help a few of our students, and she stays, and she does everything in the year. And in a wonderful collaboration with Lemont High School, we get some students back that come to help us each year. So if those Lemont High School students would come out. Zoe, Allie, and Juliana. Okay, and at this time we have a tradition to honor our eighth graders. This was their last musical with us. So if you are a first year eighth grader or a second year eighth grader, come on down. So if you've been in one or two of our shows, come on down. All right, we have in her first musical, Maddie. And Helena. Lydia. Jonathan. Prachi. Jackson. Olivia and Avery. Thank you so much for your dedication to the show this year and last year. And at this time, the hardest part for me, I get choked up. Our students who've been in the musical for all 3 years. Sixth graders, they get a ribbon, and they get the little pin in the middle, the mask and the mime, the drama symbol, and then they bring the pin back to me their second year, the ribbon back, and they get a first star for their second year, and the last star for their third year. And this is actually the first year that we've had a three-year cycle. We started 3 years ago with Annie. So we have Annie, Shrek the Musical, and Sound of Music, and I put their little pictures in there, and it's unbelievable, the growth from sixth grade to eighth grade. Taylor. Naina. Caitlin. Caroline. Peyton.
For Old Quarry Middle School, we'd like you to join along in the singing of Do Re Mi. Joined us this year. She was a fabulous addition to our team. And Miss Borcher, who isn't here, it was the art director, the scene director for all of the scenery that you see.
So, throughout all our rehearsals, we've gotten to earn a guitar pick that has set on it Sound of Music OQMS 2019. To earn this, we had to stand out to the directors. We had to know all our lines and not miss any of our cues. And we feel like there are three people here who deserve their guitar pick.
To you in living color.
Thank you.
Turn your mics on, except for Caroline. Shh.
Okay. What are we laughing
about? I mean, you're great. No, it's just like,
that is kind
you
of
see, like, I just like perfect, and then you see.
What?
What does this say?
The mics. The mics.
We need
a British
accent. We need to
learn the
British accent.
I put Mr.
Mike's now.
This is like the robot family.
Robot suddenly all came for me. You're the only one who makes me rattle and that's like a
terrible costume. I'm fine.
But you are ready. You are more than ready. You've exceeded our expectations. So I am beyond, beyond proud of you.
Che Kofisa, Kofisa la la.
No, I mean, like, it's rough.
Here,
Who wants
yes, let's go!